Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to FCCJ. I'm Haruko Watanabe, the chairperson of the Special Project Committee. But I was suddenly recruited as our president, Lucy Birmingham, who's supposed to chair, had a little light traffic accident. Before I introduce people at the head table, may I remind you to switch off your cell phones? If you haven't done so, please. Or put it on manner board. Okay, thank you very much. Well, one more reminder for security measure. If this building starts shaking, don't get panic. We have nice and responsible waiters to lead you to the safe staircase. Don't use elevators. Okay, well, my next is, I have trouble with putting Mr. or Miss or Ms. So I just simply said Yamagata Shinya-san, Higashi Koyuki-san, and Sugiyama-san, and then interpreter, usual Takamatsu-san. You speak first, right? I see. Sugiyama-san will speak first.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you very much for joining us today. I'm Fumino Sugiyama. I'm in charge of Tokyo Rainbow Pride. I'm involved with many LGBT activities, and many have thought I'm gay. But actually, I'm not. And although I may look like this, but I used to be a woman. I'm a transgender. I may have a beard like this, but I used to always wear a school girl's uniform. Can you imagine that? That is what it's like to be an unseen sexual minority. We are unseen, and we cannot state that we actually exist. For a long time, we have been treated as non-existent, but now, is the time for Japan to change. I'd like to talk with you today about Japan's current LGBT situation. ということでお話しさせていただきたいと思いますが、僕がこういった活動をする、きっかけとなったのは約10年前ですね。まだ学生だった頃に、友人の勧めで性同一性障害のカミングアウト本っていうのを出したことからでした。で、僕自身学生時代はですね、誰にも言うことができずに、自分だけが頭がおかしいんじゃないかとこう思い悩んでた時期もあって、本当に死んでしまいたいと思うほどこう悩んでいた時期もあったんですけれども、多くの友人、家族に恵まれて少しずつ、カミングアウトを、始めた頃でした。
So I would like to tell you a little bit about my background. I started basically starting these activities for LGBT about 10 years ago. At the time, I was still a student, and I took the initiative and actually produced a book, published a book talking about my coming out as a person with gender identity disorder. When I was a student, I really could not tell the people around me that I was suffering from this disorder, and in fact, I thought that maybe something was wrong with me, and sometimes I would even think about possibly killing myself. That's how unhappy I was. However, I was very, very fortunate in finding colleagues and friends and family who were able to support me, and therefore I was able to come out in a very positive way.
ちょうど写真が出てますけれども、いわゆるどこにでもいるような普通の4人家族、杉山家の次女として生まれまして、ちっちゃい方ですね。で、赤いネクタイをしたセーラー服を着ている頃、で、右下の写真がちょうど中学生の頃で一番こう体は順調に女性としてこう成長していく一方で、心の方、気持ちの方は順調に男性としてこう成長していく、こうまさにこう引き裂かれるなんて思いでは簡単な言葉では済まないような心理状況で、ずっと悩んでた、頃の写真、あとは幼稚園の頃の写真はですね、幼稚園だけ男女共学で、男女共学 で男の子たちと一緒に遊んで疑いようもなく自分が男だと思ってた時期の写真を今日ちょっと持ってきました。
So these are some photographs to show you some of my past, some aspects of my past. As you can see, I was born into a regular, normal four-person family of parents and two children. I was born as the younger daughter of the Sugiyama family. And you can see that I was just a normal little girl. And in the right bottom-hand corner, there's a picture of me when I was in junior high school. You can see that I'm wearing a regular sort of, we call it seidorfuku, or dressed in the sailor, designed in the sailor style uniform. And this was a time when my body was developing normally as a young woman. However, mentally, I was developing normally as a young man. So it's easy to simply say that I felt I was being torn apart, but it was much more complex and much more, great deal more suffering involved than just simply that. I also included a picture when I was in kindergarten, because that was the only time when I was receiving co-ed education. In other words, I was able to associate with boys. And at that time, I played with boys, and I thought without doubt that I actually was a boy.
まだその本を出した時期っていうのは性同一性障害という言葉の認知度も、ほとんどない時期でですね、まあ、セクシャルマイノリティといえばイコールあの水商売というような夜の世界の人とか、イコールテレビバラエティに出ている一部の人というイメージ、まあ、どこか自分とは遠い世界の人っていうイメージがあの強かった頃だと思うんですけれども、まあ、未だにそういう部分もあると思うんですが、まあ、そんな中で、まあ、どこにでもいそうなすぐ隣にいるような、学生で、さらにまあフェンシングの日本代表をやっているようなあの選手でもこうそういうことがあるんだということでカミングアウトしたところ、まあ、結構あの話題にしていただいたことがありました。
So at the time that I issued my book, the term gender identity disorder was not widely recognized in Japan. Whenever anyone talked about people having some kind of sexual orientation difficulties, the immediate image that came to most people's minds was people, for example, working in the night trade, or people working in on television, you know, special persons, people very much removed from our everyday world. So the fact that I came out and basically presented myself as just an average person, someone that would be, you would find around you in a normal situation, an average student, an average person, it was a very unusual kind of coming out, and as a result, I received a great deal of attention.
で自分でも思ってた以上 の, あの反響がありまして、全国から僕もそうです、私もそうですと、でも誰にも言うことができません、辛いです、苦しいです、もう助けて死にたいと、そういったメールがもう1000通を超えるようなメールをあのいただいてですね、まあ、以来そういった方たちの、まあ、相談に乗ったりですとか、全国の学校や企業、あとはあの、まあ、さまざまなあの団体で、セクシャリティに関する講演をさせていただいたり、あとあの今はパレードの運営や、セクシャルマイノリティの子どもたちのサポートを行う NPO を運営したりしながら、今は自分自身で会社を経営して、そういった活動と並行してやっております。
How, as I mentioned earlier, because it was an unusual kind of coming out for a an average person to come out in this way, it, the book received a great deal of attention throughout the nation. In fact, I received letters from all over, mails and letters from all over the nation, from young people saying that I'm very similar to you, I'm suffering in a similar way, I don't know what to do with my life, I want to kill myself. And as a result, I realized that there was a great need for my giving support to these young people. So I started giving lectures at schools and different companies and talking about sexual orientation difficulties and the problems that we face. And at present, as was mentioned by the MC, I am in charge of helping to run a parade for people with sexual orientation disorders or different choices. I am also running an NPO that helps support children who have some sort of sexual disorientation or different sexual orientation than the regular population. And in other words, they are the sexual minority. At the same time, I'm also running a company, and I'm also engaged in these various activities.
たった10年でもこの日本のセクシャルマイノリティを取り巻く環境というのはあの非常に大きく変わってきていると思うんですけれども、特に先月あの渋谷区で日本初の同性パートナー条例が可決されてからのこの3週間というのは本当に目まぐるしいスピードであの変化しているとも感じています。
I've briefly run through the changes that I've seen over the past 10 years in Japan. I think the changes have been quite drastic in society, and there's a great acceptance of people such as ourselves in Japanese society. However, things have become even more different in the last month. As you know, there was in Shibuya Ward an ordinance that was passed that permitted the recognition of same-sex partnerships. So I believe that this is going to further even greater change in the future.
この条例の件は日本だけでなくて国内外で大きく話題にもなっているんですけれども、まあ、僕は大きくなんか国を変えたいと思って始めたというよりも、ただ普通に暮らしたいというふうに思ってきただけで、本を出した時もですね、何か大きく訴えてこう社会を変えてやろうみたいなことで書いたというよりも、ただ僕は僕ですって言いたかっただけなんですね。
I would, however, I'd like to touch on the fact that there is a great deal of attention paid to people like ourselves since the coming out of, the passing of this ordinance, not only within Japan, but throughout the world. However, what I would like to make clear is that I did not set out on a mission to somehow change the world. All I am doing is asking for the right to live a normal life, just as heterosexual or other people are doing. I had the same feelings when I wrote my book. I didn't write the book to somehow drastically alter or change all of society. I just asked permission and recognition that I wanted to live as myself.
好きな人と一緒に暮らしたいというごく、まあ、シンプルな思いが数が多いという人たちには当たり前のようにできるのに、数が少ないというだけで僕たちにはできない、まあ、それはそろそろスタートラインを一緒にしていただきたいなと。そして数が多い方たちの明日は変わらないとは、この条例ができてもできなくても変わらないとは思うんですが、 そんなに変わらないと思うんですけれども、僕たちにとっては非常に大きく明日が変わる大きな一歩だということもお伝えできたらなというふうにいつも思っています。
In other words, all we are asking is for the right to live a normal life, to the right to share our lives with the people that we love, just as everyone else in the world, in society, has that right. And when you consider the fact that the majority of the people, the great numbers of people in society belong to one group, and a very small number of people belong to the group that we belong to, the fact that just because we belong to a minority, that should not preclude our being able to live a normal life. That is all we are trying to ask for. In other words, by the passing of this ordinance, we don't expect that the numbers of these two groups will change drastically in any way. But from now on, we believe that our tomorrow will be very, very different from our yesterdays.
なので今回のこの渋谷の 件というのは本当に非常にただ素直に嬉しいなというふうに思ってます。でそれは条例の中身はもちろんなんですけれども、それ以上にこの行政がその僕たちの存在をちゃんと認めてくれたと。で 渋谷区では今までいないこととされていた僕たちの存在もちゃんと存在を認めて尊重してくれる街なんだということをまず何よりも嬉しく思っています。
In other words, we are just simply extremely happy that this ordinance was passed. And of course, the contents of the ordinance is something that brings us great joy. But even more than that, the fact that such an ordinance was passed is very symbolic, because it means for the first time the government, the administration, basically recognizes our existence. Until now, there had been a kind of de facto sort of unspoken understanding that people such as ourselves did not exist and should be awarded. However, with the passing of this ordinance, it has been made very clear that the government and administration recognizes our existence, and not only that, they respect our existence.
その同性パートナーシップというとですね、性同一性障害は関係ないんじゃないかというふうに思われることもあるんですけれども、すごく大いに関係はあってですね、こう見た目はこんななんですけれども、僕自身はまだ戸籍上は女子になります。なので今5年近く付き合った女性、ストレートの女性のパートナーがいるんですけれども、こう見た目は男女異性のカップルに見えても、戸籍上は女性同士ということで一緒にいる手段がまだありません。でまあ、ならば性同一性障害特例法を使って戸籍の変更をすればいいんじゃないかと言われるんですけれども、戸籍変更の条件というのはまだ非常に厳しくてですね、条件の一つである生殖器を取り除いていることという条件に当てはまらない、僕はまだ変更ができないということで、まだ一緒にいる手段がありません。
So, in regard to this same-sex partnership ordinance that was passed, one might think that it does not apply to me because I'm in a separate category. I am a transgender, a GID, or gender identity disorder category. However, I believe that this ordinance does very much directly affect me. The reason I say this is that on the surface, I look as a man, and I have actually been with a woman, a straight woman, for the past 5 years. She is very, very dear to me. We would like very much to be a couple, and on the surface we look as though we are a couple, but according to our official family registry, because I am still legally a woman, we cannot be together. Some people might say, well, you know that there is a special exemption law for gender identity disorder people, and why don't you take advantage of that and change? change your family registry. However, to change your family registry, to change the gender, the conditions are very, very severe. And one very severe condition or hard hurdle to overcome is that in order for me to change my gender in my family registry, I would have to have surgery to remove my reproductive organs. And so far, I've not been able to make that decision. So as a result, from a family registry point of view, I cannot be with the person that I love.
できることなら僕自身はもうこれ以上体を切りたくないと、まあ、金銭的にも体も心も負担のかかる手術はもうこれ以上したくないというふうに思ってるんですけれども、やっぱり彼女と一緒にいようと思った方が、思うとですね、切った方がいいのかなと悩んだりもして、名前は性同一性障害、障害とつくんですけれども、でも保険は効かない。だけど変更、戸籍の変更の条件にはその保険適用がないその手術が必要になってくる。これはちょっと矛盾してるんじゃないかなというふうに思います。
If possible, I don't want to undergo any further surgery. I don't want to cut any other part of my body, because not only is it financially very, very difficult for me as a burden to bear, but psychologically and also physically, it is a very, very great burden for me to bear. On the other hand, however, as I mentioned earlier, I am with this woman that I love. I would very much like to legally be with this woman and that I love. I think it's a very, very paradoxical, very, very contradictory situation in that we refer to my situation as I am suffering from a disorder. It's a gender identity disorder. But although it's considered a disorder, medical insurance does not cover the surgeries that are needed. However, as I mentioned earlier, in order for me to be able to clear the hurdles to change my family registry, I would have to undergo this surgery, which is not covered by medical insurance. I would have to cut part of my body away in order to be with the woman that I love.
その自分の体の違和感ではなくて、制度に合わせるために体を切らなくてはいけないという悲しい手術がたくさん行われていて、まあ、生殖器を切れば好きな人と一緒にいる権利を、ね、国がくれるって言ったら、皆さんは自分の生殖器切りますかと。
In other words, I understand that some people undergo this kind of surgery because they are very, very uncomfortable with their physical body and they want to change it. But in my case, and in the case of many others, they undergo this kind of surgery out of a great feeling of sadness. And the only reason they undergo it is because they have to change their body to adapt to the existing system. In other words, if you were given the choice, of being of the country, the government telling you they would grant you the same human rights as anyone else, only if you undergo surgery to remove your reproductive organs, would you undergo such surgery?
そのもちろん性同一性障害特例法の条件を変更するというのもあるんですけれども、もしこの同性パートナー条例のようなものがちゃんと進んでいって、進んでいけば、こう制度に合わせるために体を切るといったようなこう不必要な手術が軽減される可能性は大きく、あるということで、今後に期待したいというふうに思っています。
Of course, I think there are several ways that one might approach this issue. Some people say, well, then why don't we just focus on trying to somehow amend or change the existing special exemption law for genetic identity disorders? That is one way, but I think there is a greater hope in trying to pool all of our resources and all of our efforts into supporting and furthering this same-sex partnership ordinance. I think if this same-sex partnership ordinance eventually proceeds, then eventually we will have a situation where people such as myself will be recognized and people such as myself will not have to undergo unnecessary and unwanted surgery.
そのただ一方でですね、今週日曜日、パレードも行われる、今度の26日の日曜日なんですが、この条例が可決された渋谷区で区長選挙があるということで、区長候補の中にはこの条例に否定的な方も、いらっしゃって、今回の選挙の結果次第では、この条例の見直しなんてこともあるんじゃないかと言われていて、今後の日本の LGBT を取り巻く環境が大いに、変わる可能性があるというふうにも思っています。
On the other hand, I think you all know that on this coming Sunday, on the 26th, not only are we having our Rainbow Pride Parade, but it is also the elections, unified regional elections, the second part of the unified regional elections that are going to be held. And actually, there are several candidates vying for the mayoral post of Shibuya Ward, the Shibuya Ward mayor position. And of the candidates that have presented themselves, some have come out being very negative about this ordinance. So depending on the result of this upcoming election, it might be that the ordinance which we are so happy had been passed might come under review. In other words, the environment surrounding us, the LGBTs, might possibly change drastically.
渋谷区からこのスタートした、この話題は全国に今広がって全国の自治体が議論を始めました、ここで渋谷区がしっかりと進めて、形作れるかどうかと、はたまた今の流れが止まってしまうのかどうかというのは今後の日本を左右する大きなポイントなんじゃないかなと思っています。
As you know, this entire movement began with Shibuya Ward, with the passing of this quite a phenomenal ordinance. And as a result, autonomous regional governments throughout the nation are beginning similar discussions about same-sex ordinances or rules. I believe, therefore, that the upcoming election on Sunday is going to be very, very crucial for the future of LGBTs in Japan.
この渋谷の条例の件はもう渋谷だけの話ではなくて日本全体の話だと思っています。で、同性パートナーの、話だけではなくて2020年東京オリンピックも決まった日本が今後しっかりとこう国際都市になっていけるのかと、多様性の先進国になっていけるのかというのを大きな分かれ道だと思っていて、まあ、少しでも多くの皆さんにこの現状をお伝えしたくて今ここでお話をさせていただいております。で、まあ、細かい話はすごくちょっと役が長くなってしまってすみません。あの細かい話は後ほど質疑応答でさせていただきますので一旦この辺で終わりたいと思います。ありがとうございました。
So, again, I would like to emphasize that this is an issue not only for the future of Shibuya Ward, but I believe it will have a great impact for all of Japan. In other words, this is not a problem that is limited only to people with certain gender issues or gays and lesbians or et cetera, but rather I think it affects all of Japan. In other words, we are going to be hosting the 2020 Olympics. I think this, how LGBTs are viewed and treated in Japan will prove how international city Japan will become by 2020, whether it is a nation that is advanced, whether it is a nation that embraces and diversity. I think we are at a crucial turning point. We could go one way or the other at this point. I'd like to go into more detail, but I've already taken up a lot of extra time, so I'd like to respond to any further questions that you may have in the later Q&A. Thank you for your attention.
それでは山形真也さん、どうぞ。
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is 真也 Yamagata.And I one of the two presidents of Tokyo Rainbow Pride. It is an honor to be here today. どうも今日はありがとうございます。私は東京レモプライドの共同代表の山形と言います。ちょうど今杉山も申しましたが、今週末、4月の25、26、渋谷区にあります代々木公園にて、東京レインボープライド2015が開催されます。
So yes, I've just introduced myself, and as Mr. Sugiyama mentioned, we are being hosting this weekend in Yoyogi Park in Shibuya Ward, a big national pride parade and festival.
今年はですね、渋谷区の同性パートナー証明の、話題もありまして、すごく盛り上がると思っています。メディアの問い合わせも、昨年の3倍ぐらいになってまして、参加者も増えると思っています。
We believe that this year's festivities will gather many, many people and garner great attention, in part because of this ordinance that was passed by Shibuya Ward. We've already received about three times the media inquiries about this upcoming event compared to last year.
私が東京のこのプライドパレードの運営に携わったのは2002年からになります。で、日本でですね、初めてこのプライドパレードが開催されたのが1994年の8月で、東京で開催されました。
I have been involved in the Tokyo Pride Parade since 2002. 2002年でよろしかったですか?
はい。
Since 2002.
私が関わったのが2002
年。 And the first such a Pride Parade was held in Japan, in Tokyo, in August of 1994.
で、まあ、これで昨年でちょうど20年ということになるわけですけども、まあ、その間、まあ、中断があったりとか、まあ、経済的な問題とかいろいろマンパワーの問題とかいろいろあって中断をしたりとかいろいろありながら、まあ、20年間、まあ、続いてきました。
So last year, we celebrated the 20th anniversary of the Pride Parade in Japan. Having said this, however, we were not able to hold these Pride Parades every single year or during those 20 years because of a lack of manpower, because of financial constraints. We were not always able to hold such events, but still we were able to celebrate our 20th anniversary.
主催団体もまあ変わったりとかしたんですけども、それでもずっと会場はですね、渋谷区代々木公園、ほとんどそこでやられていて、渋谷原宿、渋谷区界隈を行進する、してきました。
the organizations that have sponsored and arranged this Pride parade have changed over time, but still we've always centered around Yoyogi Park. We have basically paraded around the Shibuya area, the very commercial district, and also around the Harajuku area.
2012年からちょうど私どもの、主催する東京レインボープライドのパレードが、開催されまして、今年で4回目になります。はい。
So from 2012, we in the Tokyo Rainbow Pride organization have basically taken over the management or organization of this parade. This is the fourth year of our efforts.
この20年間で、まあ、かなり大きく変わってきたことがいくつかあります。まずですね、まあ、確実にあの人数は増えてまして、私どもがまあ開催してまあ4年になるんですけども、東京レインボープライドになってからでも、5000人、1万2000人、1万5000人と、これは全部あの1日開催なんですけども、で今年は2日間開催なので、だいたい3万人から5万人の動員を見込んでいます。
During the last 20 years, we have seen tremendous changes occur in the parade and the festivities. First of all, I can point out to the fact that the number of participants have increased dramatically from year to year. We have been at Tokyo Rainbow Pride. We have been doing this now for 4 years. And the first year, there were about 5,000 people. Next year, 10,000 people. The following year, 12,000 people. And last year, 15,000 people. However, all of these events were only held for just one day. This year, we're going to be holding it on 2 days, April 25th and 26th. So we expect in total 30 to 50,000 people participating in our events.
私ども の, あのイベントはですね、まあ、あの企業とかその他のところ の, あの、資金で、あの協賛金であの運営されているんですけども、この間ですね、まあ、協賛企業もかなり変化をしてまして、最初の、まあ、頃はですね、まあ、あのゲイコミュニティとか LGBT のコミュニティの中の、企業だったりとか、新宿2丁目のゲイバーだとか、そういうところからお金を集めてという形でした。
In regard to our events, we do operate, we are able to operate because we do receive support money from various companies and organizations. However, the composition of the companies that make up our sponsors have changed over time. When we first started out, it was basically companies that were associated with or part of the gay community or the LGBT community, such as gay bars in Shinjuku that offered contributions that allowed us to sponsor this event.
で、その後、企業、特にあの外資系の企業が 主なんですけども、外資系の企業からのサポートが得られるようになり、で最近では日本の企業も少しずつ、協賛をしてくださるようになりました。
After that, we began to see a great deal of support offered from foreign companies. And in recent years, we've also seen the number of Japanese companies that support us increase in numbers.
またあの会場の方もだんだんあの広くイベントの方も大きくなってまして、昨年はですねブース出展数が50だったんですけども、今年は90になって、倍近くになっています。で、主なあの企業、主なあの参加なんですけども、まあ、ブース出展に限りますと、まずあの協賛企業のブースがあります。それからまあ飲食ブース、それから LGBT のコミュニティですね、そういうコミュニティのいろんな活動している団体のブース、それからあの各国 の, あの大使館からの、ブースも、あります。
Also, over time, we've seen the amount of space that our event covers also increase. For example, last year we had about 50 booths participate in our events. This year we expect about 90. In other words, the number has almost doubled. And what kind of organizations or companies actually present booths at our event? First of all, the companies that offer our sponsorship present their booths, but also we also have booths that provide foods and drinks.And also we have booths that present the activities of different organizations in the LGBT community. And also we have begun recently to see booths that are sponsored or presented by various embassies in Japan, foreign embassies in Japan.
人数だけではなくて、あの参加者もかなり広がってきていまして、結構アジアの台湾とかタイとか、韓国とかそういうところからも、パレードに参加してくださる方が増えています。
I mentioned earlier that the number of participants in our event has increased over time, but not only that, the number of countries that they represent has also increased. We are beginning to see participants come from Taiwan, Thailand, South Korea, etc.
それからですね、いわゆるアライという、異性愛者の支援者の方ですね、そういう方の、参加も増えてまして、ボランティアスタッフなんかでも最近では、アライの方、異性愛者の方とかもたくさん参加してくださっています。
We're also very happy to report that we're also seeing the number of our supporters, people who support our activities, whom we call allies. The number of our allies who serve as volunteer staff have increased in numbers as well.
私たち、20年近く、渋谷でパレードをやってきたんですけども、今回の、3月に、可決された条例で、どこまで我々が渋谷で歩いてきたことが、影響があるか分からないですけども、私としてはやっぱり多かれ少なかれ影響を与えてきたのではないのかなと思っていまして、この度可決されたことをすごく嬉しく思いました。
So as I've mentioned, we've been holding these parades annually over the past 20 years or so. And as you know, in March of this year, the ward of Shibuya, the local assembly, passed this ordinance recognizing same-sex partnerships. Can we really draw this cause and effect line? In other words, have our parades and our activities really helped contribute to an environment that allowed for the passing of this ordinance? I'm not sure. But I think it must have had, our activities, our efforts must have had some effect. And as a result, I'm extremely, extremely pleased that this ordinance was passed.
それで、じゃあ最後に、最後になるんですけども、今回大使館からの、メッセージもいろいろいただいてるんですけども、最後にちょっと、デンマーク大使館からのメッセージをちょっとここで紹介させていただこうと思っています。デンマークというと1989年に初めて、パートナー証明、をやった国なんですけども、それで昨年で25周年ということになっているんですけども、デンマーク大使館からは、今回のパレードについて、向けて、メッセージをいただいています。ちょっと読み上げますと、同性による結婚は北欧諸国、北欧諸国で合同でブースを出すんですけども、その代表としてデンマークがメッセージをデンマーク大使館がメッセージを書いてくださいました。5カ国、ここの、デンマーク含め北欧の5カ国は同性パートナーシップとか同性婚がすべて整っている国です。同性愛者は多くのものを得られました。その法律ができたことによってですね、で自分の選んだ人と結婚でき、法的給付を受けられるようになりました。異性愛者にとっては、別に何も変わっていません。つまり同性婚を認めたからといって失うものは 何かあるのでしょうか。こういうメッセージをいただいたんですが、これが25年前の話ですけども、ようやく、日本もその端緒についたというか、今回の条例とかで、日本も大きく変わるのではないかなと思っています。
So, as I mentioned earlier, we have received the support of many different embassies in Japan, and I would like to end my comments by explaining to you, reading to you a message that we received from the Embassy of Denmark in Japan. Denmark, as you know, is very much ahead of the curve in this area. In 1998, they first passed their law, which had to do with recognizing same-sex marriages or partnerships, and last year they were able to celebrate the 25th anniversary of passing of such recognition. The five Scandinavian countries are presenting a joint booth at our event, but the Embassy of Denmark sent, as a representing all of the five Scandinavian countries, a message to us saying that the fact that our rules were changed, a law was enacted that allowed for same-sex partnerships, meant that tremendous positive changes were brought to the same-sex couples' communities. They were able to be treated fairly in society and receive the kind of benefits and salaries that heterosexual couples were able to receive. At the same time, over the past 25 years, heterosexual couples have not seen any decline in their rights or their privileges. In other words, it has had no negative effects on the general heterosexual community, while it has had very positive effects on the same-sex communities. So I believe that this is an indication that this is the direction that Japan should be heading towards.
はい、では今週末パレードの方に皆さんぜひよかったら遊びに来てください。ありがとうございました。
So we ask that you please come and join us in the festivities this weekend. Thank you very, very much.
Yeah, 最後に東小雪さんお願いします。
I'm 小雪東 living in Shibuya World with my same-sex partner. We held the first same-sex wedding at the Tokyo Disney Resort 2 years ago. My partner, Hiroko, and I would like to apply for a same-sex partnership certificate as soon as Shibuya Worlds start to issue.
改めまして、東小雪と申します。今、写真をご覧いただいていますが、私は2年前に東京ディズニーシーにて、日本のディズニーとしては初めてとなる、同性同士の結婚式を挙げました。
So, I am Koyuki Higashi, and this photograph that you are seeing right now shows you the wedding that we celebrated, my partner and I celebrated 2 years ago at Tokyo DisneySea. This was the first same-sex marriage that was ever held at Tokyo Disneyland.
もうとても幸せな経験で、結婚式を挙げられたことを今でも本当に嬉しく思っています。
It was a wonderful, wonderful experience, brought great happiness to my heart. This wedding is a treasured memory for me.
結婚式を挙げて、今は、パートナーと渋谷区に暮らしています。一緒に会社を経営していて、一緒に家事をして、時々喧嘩をしたりしながら、私はひろこさんのことをとても大切な家族だと思っています。
So my partner and I, after our wedding, have moved now to Shibuya Ward. We together run a business. We're partners in a business. We also do share housework. We often quite often fight as other couples do. I regard my partner Hiroko as being a very, very precious person to me.
私は、彼女のことをとても大切なパートナー、家族だと思っていて、結婚式を挙げて一緒に暮らしていても、日本の今の制度では、残念ながら家族として扱われません。だから、同性パートナーだから困ってしまうということがいくつかあります。例えば引っ越しをしようと思っても、同性のパートナーであるからという理由で家を借りることがとても難しいという現状があります。そして今は2人とも健康に暮らしているんですけれども、病気や事故のリスクというのは誰にでもあることです。万が一の時に病院で家族として扱ってもらえるのか、手術の同意書にサインすることができるのか、面会を必ずパートナーとして面会をすることができるのか、不安を抱えながら暮らしています。
As I mentioned earlier, I think of my partner Hiroko as a very, very special person for me, a person precious to me. In fact, I think of her as my family. And it is because I think of her in this way that we had this wedding and we have begun living together. In spite of the fact that we are indeed functioning as a family and think of ourselves as a family under the Japanese current system, we are not treated or regarded legally as a family. And what does this mean for us? It means that there are many, many problems that we encounter in real life. For example, if we were to move,it is very, very difficult for same-sex partners such as ourselves to be able to find places that will rent to us. And fortunately, as you can see by this photograph, we are both healthy and still young. But it's very possible, as it is possible for anyone, to somehow suddenly encounter an accident or to be felled by illness. And we are faced with great anxieties about how the hospital might treat us since we're not legally, legitimately wedded.In other words, will the hospital treat us as family? Will they allow us to sign consent forms for the other's surgery? Will they allow us to visit the person that is in the hospital as a member of the family or not?
法律的に何の保障もなく社会的な制度を利用できない私たちは、ルームシェアをしているお友達という扱いに過ぎません。そのために今お話ししたことのほかに、さまざまな社会的な生きづらさを抱えているのが現状です。
In other words, legally, there are many, many constraints on us there, and we do not have the same legal guarantees that heterosexual couples can enjoy. We cannot live together as legal wedded partners. In fact, although I say we live together as a family, what we are actually regarded as are two friends that are sharing a room.
私は金沢市の出身なんですけれども、初めて同性が好きだと気がついたのは、16歳の春、高校2年生の頃のことでした。学校のクラスメートの女の子への気持ちが、あ、これは恋愛感情なんだと気づいたことがありました。その時、当時の金沢には LGBT に関するポジティブな情報はもうほとんどなくて、同性愛であるということは人に話してはいけないことだ。親や学校の先生、お友達にも言ってはいけないことなのではないかと思い、とても辛い経験をしました。
I originally came from Kanazawa Prefecture, I first realized that I was attracted to the same sex as myself when I was 16 years old. I was in the second year of high school. It was a spring, and I still remember that the feelings that I had for a classmate were very much romantic feelings. And at that time, however, in Kanazawa, there was almost no positive information about people with that or belonged to the category of LGBTs. All I felt was that I had these feelings, but it would be very, very wrong and very, very perhaps dangerous to tell anybody about them, whether it was my family or my teachers or my friends.
今でも LGBT の子どもたちは自殺のリスクが高い、いじめられてしまう可能性もあるというふうに言われています。
Even now, children suffering, children with, that belong to the LGBT category are said to suffer from a higher suicide risk and higher rates of bullying, being bullied, excuse me.
今回渋谷区の条例が可決された時、私はパートナーと一緒に議場におりました。可決された瞬間は本当に感動してとても嬉しくて涙が出てきました。
When the Shibuya Ward local assembly passed this ordinance, I was actually in the assembly room with my partner, and at the moment that they ratified it or passed this ordinance, I remember how happy we were both were. We were both in tears.
これは今私とひろこさんが使えるようになるから嬉しいというだけではなくて、やはりまだ自分の性的指向だったり自分の在り方を肯定的に捉えることができない次の若い世代にもとてもポジティブなメッセージになったと思います。私たち大人はこれからどうやってこの条例が全国に広がっていくのか、きちんと運用されていくのかを見守って、日本の社会がどんな属性を持った人にも暮らしやすいものになってほしいと心から思っています。今日はありがとうございました。
So, the reason that my partner Hiroko san and I were so full of great joy was not because that our lives, our two lives, would be greatly enhanced as the passing of this ordinance, but we also realized that there were so many people like us, especially young people, who still had not come to terms with their particular sexual orientation, who still did not know exactly how they were going to live their lives, and who were suffering a great deal. I think that the passing of this ordinance presented a very positive and hopeful message to such people who were burdened by such suffering. I therefore think that our next task is to carefully watch and see how this ordinance eventually spreads throughout Japan, how similar ordinances or rules spread throughout Japan, how also this ordinance is actually implemented is also a very, very important thing for us. We believe that eventually, and we hope eventually, that Japan will be a nation where people, regardless of what kind of a group you might belong to, you can all find happiness.
Thank you very much. Now there are entertaining questions. When you like to ask questions, please limit your question to one and no comment or preambles. And also state your name and affiliation before you ask questions. Since we do not offer honorary membership for this conference, and Park decided to offer a cup of coffee or tea. それでは質問のある方はどうぞ。プレスクラブのレギュラーメンバーから始めます。Please state your name and affiliation. Are you a member of press club?
Yes.
Yes, please, go ahead.
インドネシアの新聞記者なんですけれども、リチャード・スシローと申します。何千回ぐらい記者会見参加したのに、今、一番混乱してるなんですけれども。質問ということは杉山さんにちょっと質問したいなんですけれども、はい、2年間の間に、バックパックで生活で、世界的、50カ国、これすごいじゃない、坊ちゃんじゃないですか、これはお嬢様ですね、これはいつからいつまでですか、何年から何年までですか、それからその50カ国の中でインドネシアにも行ったことがありますでしょうか。でこの2年間の中で、何が探してるんですか、自分のアイデンティティが探してるんですか、それは気になるなんで、で結果はどんな結果ですか、この50カ国の中で。お願いします。
Very inclusive one question. Will you please answer?
よろしいですか。
じゃあ、はい。
はい。
時期はですね、ちょうど大学院を、卒業した頃だった25歳ぐらいだったんですけれども、あのダブルハッピネスという自身の、性同一性障害のカミングアウト本を出しまして、それの、そこから得たお金を元に旅をしました。でその時にまだ戸籍上ももちろん女子ですし、こんなにヒゲも生えていなかったので、もう世界中のパスポートコントロールのところで C なのか He なのかと、ミスターなのかミスなのかムシなのかマドモアゼルなのかミーゴなのかミーガなのかと、まあ、聞かれまして、でやっぱりどこに行ってもこのセクシャリティというのは、まあ、どんな国に行ってもやっぱりついて回るんだなと。でインドネシアにはその時はそのタイミングでは行かなかったんですけれども、あのフェンシングのジュニアの代表として中学生の時に試合に行ったことがありますが、その時はまだそこまでちょっとセクシャリティのことを、そこまで記憶にない時なんですけれども、でも世界中ではやっぱり国によってすごくオープンなところもあればすごくクローズなところもあるというのをすごく感じました。なので今回のパートナー条例みたいなのができた時に、まだ早いとか海外の話だっていうふうに言われますけれども、できてる国はできてるんですよね。でもう海外ではなく、これだけ情報も人も移動している中で、日本はまだまだ議論がもっと慎重に議論した方がいいって言いながらですね、進めるのはどうなのかなと。もうどんどんできみんなができないんだったら仕方がないかもしれないですけれども、できてるとかもできてるんですよね。でデンマークなんかもう25年前です。でそれだけ遅れてるっていうことも早く気づいてですね、慎重にというよりもしっかりと進めていってほしいなというふうに思っています。
So the question basically goes about this 2 years that Mr. Sugiyama spent backpacking and visited 50 countries. And did he visit Indonesia? The gentleman is from Indonesia. And what were you searching for? And did you find anything? So I traveled when I was just graduating from graduate school. I was 25 years old. I mentioned earlier that I'd issued this coming out book talking about my gender identity disorder. The title of the book was Double Happiness. Now I made some money off of the book, and so I used that to travel around the world. At that time, I was still and still am in my family registry a woman. I didn't quite look the way I looked today. I didn't have a beard yet, but still, every time I went through immigration customs in different countries, I was always asked, what exactly are you? Are you a Mr. or a Miss or Mrs.? In other words, I realized that this idea of gender orientation is something, sexual orientation is something that follows you regardless of where you travel throughout the world. During those 2 years, I did not have an opportunity to go to Indonesia, but I did have an opportunity to go to Indonesia during junior high school when I went as part of a fencing team. At that time, I was not that aware of my sexual orientation. But again, during my travels abroad, I realized that depending on countries, there are some countries that are very advanced, open about these issues, and some that are very, very closed. And so when this same-sex partner ordinance was passed in Japan, I know that there have been people who are saying it's too early for Japan. Japan should discuss this more carefully and more cautiously. But Japan is not like other countries abroad. However, in an age where everything travels, goods, people, money travels so fast between nations, there is no overseas and domestic really anymore. You look at a country such as Denmark, 25 years they've already had this law on their books. I think instead of saying that Japan needs to discuss this more, I think Japan needs to become aware that it is actually later falling behind the curve on this issue.
Hi, dozo.
フランス展というインターネットテレビの記者の及川と申します。9年前にゲイアットパリ現代フランス同性愛治療という本を400ページぐらいの本を出しているんですけれども、そこで、フランスの場合は98年にパクスという同性パートナーシップ法ができまして、そして2012年に同性婚が認められました。質問は1点です。友人で、鹿児島出身でゲイの方がいるんですけども、どうしても上京したらいろいろ出会いの場とか、あと自己肯定してくれる人がいるというんですけども、鹿児島にいた時は自分の性的指向も言えないし、言える人がいなかったし、あと出会いの場もなかったとおっしゃっていました。そこで伺いたいのは、都市部だとまだいいと思うんですけども、東京あるいは大阪とか、地方の同性愛者あるいはトランスジェンダー LGBT の人たちをどのようにして支援していけばいいとお考えでしょうか。あとこれはもう一点ちょっとしたことなんですけども、昨年 ゲイパレード、ゲイプライドに、安倍昭恵さんがご参加されて、インタビューさせていただいたんですが、今年は参加のご予定とかあるかご存知でしょうか。以上2点です。失礼します。
あ、いいですか。じゃあ、トランスレート。
Excuse me, so I am from France 10, and I have already put out a 400-page book about the situation for same-sex partnerships in France, and as you know, they have passed a same-sex partnership law, and it has also have recognized same-sex marriages. But my question very quickly is that I have a friend who came from Kagoshima, and he said that once he came to Tokyo, he was able to find people to support him. He was able to find people where he could meet people with the same sexual orientation. But when he was living in Kagoshima, he could not really confide his sexual orientation thoughts to anyone else, and there was no place for him to meet other people. The point is, in urban areas such as Tokyo and Osaka, you might be able to find people who can live quite comfortably if you are part of the LGBT group. But however, how do you intend to support, or how can you support people who are of the LGBT category in rural areas? And also, last year, Ms. Akie Abe participated in your events. Do you think she will do so this year?
Yes, sorry.本当に地方との差というのは大きくてですね、こう東京だから話せる人もいるけど、地方だと誰にも言うことができないと、で、自分は言ったとしても、もし家族までそうやって変な目で見られたらどうしようということで言えない当事者は非常に多いです。だからこそさっきの話に戻りますけれども、こういった制度ができる、行政が認めるということが非常に大きくてですね、なので渋谷だけじゃないと、渋谷が成功するということがちゃんとそうやって行政でできたんだというふうになると、また地方に地方の行政でもできるんじゃないかということが非常に大事になってくると。で、先ほども申したんですけれども、やっぱりそういったこと、今回渋谷がちゃんとスタートできるかどうかっていうところに大きくこの全国の広がりもかかっていると思っていて、でそんな中でやっぱり反対される方まだまだ多いんですけれども、認めるとか認めないというよりもすでにいるんですよね。で、困ってるっていうことが、困っている人たちというのがこう今困っている、しっかり議論してなんて言ってる前に、今困っている人たちをどうするのかというのが非常に大事 でなので、ちょっとそれを反対されるような方たちというのも、今一度やっぱりこういった違いに問題があるのか、違いを受け入れない社会に問題があるのかということも考えていただきたいですし、だから今度の本当に26日というのがすごく大事になってくるというふうに思っています。で、今まで 5.2% という数字、よく LGBT 日本の人口では 5.2% と言われてきたんですけれども、実はちょうど今日発表になりました電通総研さんのアンケート調査、7万人を対象に調査を行ったところ、実は 5.2% から開設されて 6.7%、 7.6% の人口アンケートの調査では LGBT だという回答があったというふうに報告も受けています。
And I certainly understand what you're saying about the difference between urban areas and rural areas, that it is alright to be part of the LGBT category in Tokyo because you can find people to confide in and people who will support you, but it is very, very difficult to speak up if you live in a local area. There is always the great fear, especially among young people, that the news might reach their own parents' ears and that their parents might look at them in a very, very different manner. That's why we believe so strongly that this ordinance, the Shibuya Ward Ordinance, is so important and that it must start off successfully. It must be implemented successfully, because if the implementation goes well and it does not, it is regarded in a positive light here in Tokyo, then it could provide an incentive for similar ordinances to be adopted throughout the nation in rural areas as well. As I said earlier, everything depends on whether this as special ordinance that was passed will be operated or implemented well. As I mentioned earlier, we do have some anxieties in this regard because there are some opposition. There are some candidates who have already expressed opposition or reservations about this ordinance and have even said that they might possibly review it and think about it from scratch again. But what I would like to say to these people who are considering such things is to say, we're not asking you to recognize this or not recognize this or acknowledge or not acknowledge this. The point is we already exist. And although some people are calling for more serious debate, more a careful debate before doing anything, please also realize that not only do such people exist already in Japan, many people are already facing grave and serious difficulties in their everyday lives. And isn't it one's job in public office to try to take care of these people who are facing serious difficulties? So that is why we believe that this upcoming election connection is so, so very important. It is often said, as a side note, that 5.2% of the population of Japan fall into the LGBT category. This has been said for some time. However, it was today announced by Dentsu Soken, which is a research organization, and they did a survey conducted among a random population of 70,000 people, and they revised that figure from 5.2% to 7.6%.
すみません、安倍晋三首相、昭恵夫人参加のご予定はございません。
At this point, we have no knowledge of Ms. Abe. There seems to be no plan of Ms. Abe to attend this year's festivities.
The press club and the special guests agreed to extend this meeting for 10 more minutes. So you have, I don't know, maybe two people may ask questions.はい、どうぞ。Oh, I see. Yeah. No question?
I have a question.
Oh, yes, please. Well, first come, first served. Raise your hand very high so that I can recognize you.
下のモトールと申します。4月26日投開票の渋谷区長選についてお伺いします。新しく区長になる方の期待される同性パートナーシップの運用もしくは、条例に反対されている方がもし区長になった場合の不安されている部分についてお伺いいたします。
はい、
どなたにですか。
So I'm a freelance. So I'm a freelance journalist. In regard to the upcoming Shibuya Ward mayoral elections, can you tell us some of your expectations and hopes about what the new mayor will do in terms of implementation of this new ordinance? And also, if a person who opposes this ordinance were to be elected, what are some of the fears that you have?
今回区長選に出られている4名の方の中の1人長谷部健さんという方がもともと今回の同性パートナーシップ条例を3年前に提案してくださった方なので、まあ、彼になってもらえればどんどん本当に進めていけるだろうというふうに期待をしているんですけれども、まあ、他の候補者の方ではもし自分が区長になったらもうそんなの絶対廃止すると明言されている方もいらっしゃいますし、まあ、そこまで反対と言わないまでも慎重に慎重にとしっかり議論してからというようなことで言われている方と思いますので、でも本当に慎重に議論している場合じゃない、本当にもう今にもこう手首を切ってしまいそうな子どもたちがいたりする中で、それはもう時間をかけて何かと3年前に提案してそれでも議論がされてないというのであれば、それはもっとスピード感を持って変えていかなければいけないことなんじゃないかなというふうに思っています。
So of the four candidates that are running for office, one person, Mr. Ken Hasebe, was actually a member of the local assembly, and he was the one who 3 years ago basically proposed this ordinance. And so if he were to win the election, of course, I believe that this or the implementation of this ordinance and things surrounding the LGBT environment would move forward in a very positive way. In regard to the other candidates,there are people who are saying very clearly that I'm completely against this ordinance, and if I'm elected, I will completely eliminate this ordinance or make it completely ineffective. There are other candidates who are saying that they're not necessarily opposed to it, or that they will eliminate this ordinance, but they want to have more serious long-term discussions and approach this matter more carefully. But again, as I said, there is no time. We don't have time to have serious long debates anymore. After all, 3 years ago, this was first presented. It has already been debated already. We don't have time because there are children out there, young people out there who are suffering and who are thinking about cutting their own wrists. That is how much fear and suffering that they are under. We have to take care of them.
渋谷区長選は本当に大切な選挙です。LGBT の人にとってもそうでない人にとっても大切です。なぜかというと、マイノリティが生きやすい多様性を認める社会というのは、マジョリティの人たちにとっても必ず暮らしやすい社会だと思います。この動きを止めないで全国に広げていくためにも、若い世代の人、特に若い世代の人に必ず投票に行ってほしい。選挙権のある方はよく考えて必ず選挙に行って投票していただきたいと思っています。
I believe very, very strongly that this upcoming election is terribly important, not only for the LGBT community, but for people who are not part of that community. In other words, if one creates a society where even minorities, even people of diverse backgrounds are able to live comfortably, that means the people who belong to the majority group will also find it an easier society in which to live. So I would like to take this opportunity to encourage voters, especially young voters, because it is your future that you are deciding, to please think about the responsibility that you have, the privileges you have of being able to vote, and go to the polls on Sunday.
Okay. My name is Khalil Hassan. I am ambassador of Bahrain, but I originally was a pediatric surgeon.
So you're ambassador of
Bahrain.
Bahrain. Excuse me. Thank you. Bahrain の大使でございます。そしてそれだけではなく、私は小児科の外科手術の先生でございます。
For what I was dealing with babies after they are born, they had intersex, and you have to fix them.
つまり小さいお子様が生まれた後に何かそういうまあ、問題があった時にはやはりそれを直さなきゃいけない、まあ、それが私の仕事でもあったんですが、
An incidence of intersex is high in babies for that, but you find out the problem, they're mixed in sex and you fix it, but there is an anatomical problem that a male looks like a femaleOr if a female look like a male, and you fix this, everything is okay.
なんかまあ、人体的に時々男であるか女性であるかっていうのがはっきりしないときに、まあ、どっちかの方に直せば大体問題が解決する。
In my experience, I got once two girls. They were sisters. One was 18, one was 16. And from investigation, we find out they are not.Yes, they were boys, and we simply changed them to their own sex. But the genitalia from outside looked different than inside. For that, we fixed them to their original sex.
まあ、私の経験でございますが、まあまあ、小さなお子さんだけではなく、まあ、結構成人した、まあ、結構年も重ねたような方たちをに対して手術を行ったことがあるんです、まあ、自分の経験を申し上げますと、2人の姉妹18歳と16歳、まあ、女の子がいたんでございますが、まあ、いろんな精密なその検査をしましたら本当はこの2人は本来は男であるべきだったというのが分かったんでございます。その、いわゆるその性器でございますが、その体内の性器と体外の性器が間違ってたということですので、その体外の性器を手術で治して、それで問題が解決したということです。
Now, my question for you. Now, this is when person is born with intersex, different sexes. But in your case, you are talking about people who had their sex normal, but their orientation, okay? They are completely a female, but they feel from brain side.They are males, or the opposite, that they are males, but from brain side, they feel they are, the other sex. This is my question. This is really the feeling when you are talking about sex orientation, that your body is a sex, but you're thinking is the other sex. What is, Yanni, that's what I want to understand. Thank you very much.
すみません、結局その、まあ、同性愛者、ということとその今まで話が出ておりましたその、性的その思考というのはちょっと違うものかもしれません。すみません、性同一、まあ、GID ですか、性同一障害、性障害とはまたちょっと違うかもしれないんですけど、私はその皆さんが抱えているその、まあ、問題というのが、皆さんがその考え方をもっとより深く理解したいというふうに思っております。例えばその、同性愛者といいますのは、自分が女性であることには間違いない、それに対しては満足であるということでございますよね、あるいは男性であるということに満足であるんですけれど、気持ちとしては、まあ、本当ですれば異性を愛する気持ちが、まあ、同じ性の人を愛するということなんでしょうか。別に自分が内面的にちょっと違う性であるということは考えないんですけれど、異性じゃなくて自分と同じ人を好きだっていうことなんでしょうか。そこはなんか私はあまりよく理解できないので、やっぱり医者ですので外科手術をしておりますので、
まず私から
お話しさせていただきたいんですけれども、おそらくあの性文化疾患のことをあのお尋ねになっていらっしゃったのかなと思います。生まれてきた赤ちゃんの手術ということでしたので、今ここに当事者が並んでおりますけれども、私は、赤ちゃんの時に体が女性に生まれて、お医者さんが女の子だよっていうふうに判断して、大きくなったんですね。で、思春期になって女性の特徴、体の特徴が現れて、私の体は今女性です。で、そして私は自分のことを女の人だと思っています。ここがすごく大切なポイントで、私は体が女性で自分のことを女性だと思っていて、女性に恋をするレズビアンの女性なんですね。そこにパートナーが座っていますけれども、私は女の人が好きだからといって男の人だと思っていたりとか、男の人になりたいという人ではありませんし、体はおそらく、まあ、普通という言い方が、ね、正しいかどうかわからないですけれども、女性の特徴を持った体をしていると思います。
So you talked about operating on very young children, and I think you were talking about this disorder, which is this intersex or mixed sex, which sometimes appears in some bodies. But for me, just to be clear, I was born a girl. The doctor announced when I was born that I was a healthy baby girl, and I went through puberty and developed female growth as a healthy young girl. And even today, I think of myself as a woman. However, in other words, all of the characteristics of my physical body are of a woman, and I think of myself as a woman. I'm happy with myself. However, I have fallen in love with women. In other words, I am a lesbian. That's my sexual orientation. But just because my partner is sitting out in the audience, and I love her very, very much. But just because I love women, I love a woman, does not mean that I want to be a man or that I think of myself as a man. It sounds perhaps the word ordinary person, ordinary woman, is not the most appropriate term to use. But I think of myself as an ordinary woman. The only thing that is different is that I love women, people of the same sex.
性同一性障害については杉山さんからお話しいただければと思うんですけれども、私同性愛者と、性同一性障害の方、それからご質問いただきました性文化疾患の方では、共通する悩みもありますが、また違った課題に直面することもあるということを、お伝えしておきたいと思います。
I believe that in regard to gender identity disorders and the problems that such people face and the way that they think about themselves, I think Mr. Sugiyama can talk about that. And in regard to the kinds of disorders that you mentioned earlier, where a person is, of, as you said, I guess, mixed sex, that's a completely different situation. However, the problems that we all face, the challenges that we face, the difficulties that we face, I believe are very, very similar.
Mas-僕は性同一性障害ということで、戸籍上で見れば女性で、女性が好きというと、同性愛というような言い方をされることもあるんですけれども、感覚としては、僕と男として、女性が好き、感覚としては異性愛という、ちょっと頭が混乱しちゃうんですけれども、考えるときに、体の性別、いわゆるフィジカルな性別と、あと心の性別、気持ちの性別ですね、自分が男であるとか女であると思っている、そして対象の性がどちらに向くか、性指向、セクシャルオリエンテーション、この3つの組み合わせで分けて考えていただくといいかなと。そういうことでいうと、小雪ちゃんは体は女の子、気持ちも私と思っていて女性が好きだけど、僕の場合は体は女だけれども、気持ちはずっと僕男と思っていて、女性が好きで、もっとややこしくなっちゃうんですけれども、僕のような状態で男性が好きっていう人もいるんですね。だから女性が好きだから男っぽくしているということではなくて、その性の対象と自分のアイデンティティがどこにあるかっていうのはまた別の話かなというふうに思います。で、これちょっと余談になっちゃうんですけど、さっき旅の話があったんですけど、僕今まで人生トータル60カ国ぐらい行ったことがあるんですけれども、唯一入れなかった国がバーレーンなんですね。で、それは入国審査の時に、そのひげ面でお前フィーメルって何なんだと言われて、で、僕自身は英語で、一応これこれこうでと、日本では今まだ戸籍が変えれなくてと言ったら、タイとかフィリピンから来たお前と逆のやつは見たことあるけど、お前みたいなの初めてだと、ちょっと待っとけって言われて、20時間飛行場で待った挙句の果てに入国拒否ということで入れず、そのまま帰ったということがあってですね、やっぱりその情報がまだまだ少ないのかなというふうに思いますので、ぜひそういった情報をしっかり共有していただけるとありがたいなというふうに思います。
In my case, I believe, according to my family registry, biologically, I am considered to be a woman. However, I think of myself as boku, which is the Japanese word for I that only men use. In other words, that's the personal pronoun that I use, the male personal pronoun. In other words, when we think about this whole LGBT category, I think there are three factors that you need to take into consideration. One is the actual physical anatomy of that person, the gender of that physically of that person, and then there is also what I would call the heart identity, the psychological identity, how that person feels, which gender that person feels he or she is, regardless of that anatomy that person possesses. And then the third aspect is the sexual orientation. Does the person like women or does the person like men, regardless again of their anatomy and regardless of how they think of themselves as man or woman? So it's very, very complicated, but Koyuki-san sitting next to me, she thinks of herself as a woman, she thinks of herself as a girl, but she also likes girls. I myself am actually physically a woman, but I think of myself as a man, and I also like girls, or I like women. There are people also like me, in other words, anatomically, physically, a woman, who think of themselves as men, who like men, not girls. In my case, I like women, so I think of myself as basically being a heterosexual couple, except that anatomically, physically, still I'm regarded as a woman. And I would also like to clarify, I'm not trying to act as a man just simply because I like women. It's because I think of myself as a man that I am acting and dressing and behaving in this way. And just as a side note, because you mentioned that you were from Bahrain, I mentioned earlier that I traveled in 50 countries over 2 years, but actually over my lifetime, I've traveled in 60 countries. The only country in the world that I was not able to enter was your country, because when I tried to go through immigration, they looked at my passport and said, it says woman, but at that time I had a beard, and they said, who are you, what are you, and why do you have a beard, and why are you listed as a woman, and we don't know how to deal with you, so wait while we try to figure it out. And they said also that, and I explained in my English, that because of these state legal reasons in Japan, I could only list myself as a woman on my passport, but I went into all of this explanation, and they said, we actually have some visitors from the Philippines who are in exactly the opposite situation, in other words, males who think of themselves as women and dress as women, but we've never experienced someone like you. But anyway, we have to look into this matter. I was asked to wait at the airport for 20 hours, but finally denied entrance into the nation. And so I had to go home. So I realized even then that there are still, you know, some areas of the world where there is not yet complete understanding or complete information about us. And I hope that eventually this will change.
Okay. This is the last question from moderator. Nihon dewa kabuki ありますよね、オールメール、エンターテインメント、それは宝塚がありますよね、はい、もう女性がキャーっとして行ってますよね、でこれ多分日本のボーイフレンドがセクシーでもないし旦那がちょっと退屈だからだとは思うんですが、文化とかエンターテインメントの面ではもう全然問題がありませんよね、うん、ところが社会とか社会条例とかになるとどうして同一のユニティを拒否するのか、一体どういう理由があるのかというふうに思われますか？小雪さん、まずお願いします。
難しい質問ですね。
In Japan, we have the kabuki, we have the takarazuka. These are all male troops and all female troops. Probably the women that go to visit the takarazuka are very bored with their boyfriends and their husbands. That's why they go and have romantic feelings that are presented in the takarazuka theater. The point I'm making is that in the entertainment and cultural world, there is not so much discrimination against people of the LGBT category. But when it comes to society, when it comes to social rules and social ordinances, there seems to be a crackdown on same-sex partnerships. Why do you think this is so?
私は宝塚歌劇団におりまして、花組で男役をしていた経験があります。
すみません。
はい。それで
存じ上げませんでした。
そうでしたか。そうでしたか。それで今それで宝塚のご質問をいただいたのかなと思ったんですけれども、在団中カミングアウトすることができませんでした。よく女性だけの集団だし、宝塚なんだからカミングアウトしやすかったんじゃないのとか、演者の中には宝ジェンヌの中にはやっぱりレズビアンの人いるんじゃないのっていうふうに聞いていただくんですけれども。やっぱりご質問いただきましたように中でもそのオープンにするというのは非常に難しくて、ファンの方にも、なんて言ったらいいんでしょう、やっぱりこう カミングアウトしづらい空気というものようなものを私は財団中に感じていました。宝塚は100年の歴史があるんですけれども、カミングアウトをしている、した生徒は私一人、先ほど 7.6% という数字がありましたけれども、4000人以上の生徒を輩出した宝塚の中で、たった一人という方が私は不自然だと思いますし、そういった圧力、カミングアウトしづらいような圧力がこれからどんどんなくなっていってほしい、多様な女性が活躍してほしいと私は心から思っております。
The MC did not know this, but actually I believe, I actually belong to the Takarazuka theater troupe. I belong to the Hana or Flower group, and I played the part of males in the presentations there, the shows there. However, while I was in Takarazuka, I was not able to come out. And quite often I'm asked, because it's an all-female troupe, and obviously there must be some lesbians in that troupe, wouldn't it have been easier, wouldn't it have been quite easy to come out? But the reality is, suggested by the questioner, in actual society, it is very, very difficult to come out. And there, in regard to how the fans might possibly react, there is this kind of feeling within the organization that if you are of that inclination, you should keep it to yourself. You should not come out and make this public. Takarazuka is a theater group that has a very long history, over 100 years. It has produced over 4,000 students during this past century. And it was mentioned earlier that 7.6% of the population are supposed to be of LGBT category. However, of the 4,000 students plus that it has produced over the past 100 years, I am the only person that has ever come out. And I think that is because that it's not because they're not other people like me, but there is a kind of oppressive feeling in that group and throughout all of society where people cannot feel free to come out. And I hope that eventually this changes so that people do not feel this pressure to keep silent, but people are able to live in diverse ways in society.
ファンの人の中にもそういった文化を楽しむ人たち、演者の側の方にもファンタジーであることはいいけれども、実際に同性愛というのは受け入れられないいけないというような規範があるのではないか、そのファンタジーを見て楽しむ分には許容されるけれども、でもそれは宝塚の場合はあくまでも男と女異性愛の夢だっていうことになっているし、そういったところがやっぱり実際の生活だったり制度だったりっていうところとあくまで文化っていうところには大きな隔たりがあるのではないかなと思っています。
And even though there is probably this feeling within the among the fans that there is they are falling in love in kind of in adoration of other females, most of the Takarazuka audiences are made of composed of females, and they quite often idolize other female stars who play the roles of men. And although it seems that there would be permission, therefore, to come out as a person of the same-sex orientation, the reality is that culture and entertainment, the ideal of having this dream of adoring other females is allowed, but in reality, it's not something that is accepted. In fact, although it is an all-women's troupe, the stories that are presented is love between males and females. They don't present stories where there are love stories between females and females. So again, I think it has to do with, even within the cultural world, there are systems and rules that are more or less put into place.
どうして社会制度の中では認められないんですか？
僕は単純に知らないというだけだと思うんですね。まず知るということが一番大事。今回のセクシャルマイノリティの課題を考えるとき、一番のキーワードは目に見えないということだと思うんですね。なので多分今日ここにこうやって座って話してますけども、全然違うトピックを話してれば、もちろん僕が元女性であるとか2人が同性愛であるということは分からずに話は進むと思うんですけれども、それくらいやっぱりいないのではなくて言えないという現実があって、こう言わないから言えないからいない人になっているという現実があると。まあ、そこを単純に、まあ、知ってしまえばすぐ隣にいる人なんだよと、こうテレビの世界の人じゃなくて、夜の世界の水商売の人だけではなくて、普通に生活しているクラスの中の友達かもしれないし、オフィスの中にもいるかもしれないし、もしかしたらご兄弟ご両親、ね、お父さんお母さんだからって言って本当に異性愛なのか、僕の友人でも、友人のお父様がゲイなんですけれども、僕の友人も知りません。そのくらい皆さんやっぱり日本の社会に合わせて世間体というのを保つために、自分を押し殺して暮らしている方がたくさんいらっしゃる。 まあ、それが現実なんじゃないかな。だからまずは本当に知ってほしいなと、それ以上のことは逆にあまり望んでいなくて、いるんですよと、隣にもいますよということをまず知っていただけたら、その意識が変われば、本当にこうやって記者会見なんかやらせていただいてるのも、まあおかしいなというか、こんなに話題にならなくても良くなればいいなと、好きな人と一緒にいたいと思った時にみんなに開かれた同性婚異性婚ではなくて、全ての人に開かれたパートナーシップ制度があるということが大事だと思ってますし、だからまずはとにかくその存在を知ってもらいたいなというふうに思います。
So in regard to the question, why doesn't society accept what you are saying or accept your existence, and the simple answer is that they don't know about us. Most of people in society don't even know we exist, and so I think the first step is trying to gain more awareness of the factthat we do exist, that there are people with different sexual orientations or different gender disorders. The fact is that to the average eye, we simply do not appear in people's field of visions. And it's, in fact, if we were here at the same table doing a press conference on a completely different topic, you would probably not even know that we had particular sexual orientations or that I was on my family registry labeled as a woman.The thing is, we're not able to speak out, and because we're not able to speak out, people don't realize that we exist. And if people think about us at all, they think of people, a limited number of people who are on television as some kind of celebrities, or they think of people who are working in the night entertainment districts. But the reality is that we exist in large numbers, and exist in offices. We might be the office worker next to you. We might be your next door neighbor. We might even be your parents or your siblings. I have a friend whose father is gay, and my friend doesn't even know that yet. I mean, that's how hard people basically are trying to kill who they really are and hold down who they really are in order not to make waves. So all I'm asking is that you just know about us. More than that, I really cannot expect or even hope for. When you think about it, the fact that we have to have a press conference of this nature in itself is a rather sad and situation, because all we are asking for, we're not asking for special privileges, we're just asking for the right to exist, to be acknowledged, and to also be with the persons that we love just like everyone else.
その LGBT の人に会ったことがないっていうふうによく言われるんですけれども、それは会ったことがないんじゃなくて気づかなかっただけなんじゃないかなというふうに思います。で、よくどんな数字と近いのかって言った時に、日本の佐藤さん、鈴木さん、高橋さん、田中さん、この4名の名字っていうのが日本で一番多い名字のトップ4なんですけれども、皆さんきっと佐藤さん、鈴木さん、高橋さん、田中さんってお友達絶対2人や3人以上にいらっしゃいますよね。でもその数字というのは実は約 5% ぐらいと言われてますので、今回の 7.6% 世の中の佐藤さん、鈴木さん、高橋さん、田中さんよりもはるかに多い LGBT の人たちが存在するっていうふうに考えると、あれいないと思ってたけど実はもうちょっといるのかなっていうのがちょっと感覚としてはつかみやすいかなというふうに思います。
I would also just like to add one last point. Quite often I'm told that I understand what you're saying, but I don't know any LGBT people. I've never met one in my life. And I think the reality is that you have met them, you just didn't realize that they were of that category. The reason is, if we look at this from just a numerical point of view, I said earlier that there are 7.6% of the population, according to the latest surveys, that are in the LGBT category. When you look at the most popular surnames in Japan, the most popular surnames are Sato, Suzuki, Takahashi, and Tanaka. And I'm sure everyone in this room knows a couple of people of that name. Well, they together represent only 5% of the population. That means the LGBT category is 7.6%. If you know a couple of these of people with these surnames, you probably already know a couple of LGBTs without realizing it.
Okay, thank you very much. This is very educational press conference. And now you know which resource you have to approach.When you like to do the investigation and some serious reporting about LGBT. Thank you very much for your attendance. Please come back. The session closed.
ありがとうございます。